Monday, April 28th, 2003. I am blessed with faithful family and friends who regularly pray for my hospice work. Yesterday, a friend prayed that the Lord would work powerfully through me. I believe that prayer was answered today. A pastoral counselor asked if I would come immediately to the adjoining unit to encourage a patient named Henry to let me play for him. He was a very angry man who was, in the opinion of the counselors, also suicidal. Henry couldn't believe that he had to die when he hadn't even reached 60 years old. I prayed before I entered his room, and to my delight, Henry was excited to hear me play. I began with a piece called Première Gymnopédie, which is rather melancholy, because I thought he might be grieving, even though it was coming out in anger and frustration. Henry said he liked classical music, so I asked if he'd like me to play Clair de Lune. He eagerly agreed. As soon as I started playing, I had a strong feeling I was supposed to play the song You Are Mine for Henry. For the next 5 minutes as I played Clair de Lune, this inner debate ensued, not with an audible voice of God, but with the knowledge that I was to play the song You Are Mine for Henry. Play Henry, You Are Mine. But Lord, I don't even know if he has a religion. It might offend him. Play You Are Mine for Henry. Are you sure, Lord? What if he doesn't like it? You must play Henry, You Are Mine. What if it sets him off and he decides to get me in trouble? Play Henry, You Are Mine. Maybe I'm just making up both ends of this conversation in my own mind. No, play Henry, You Are Mine. I finished Clair de Lune and Henry loved it. I went to his bedside and asked if he'd ever felt he was supposed to do something, but had argued with himself whether it was right or not. I have a strong feeling I'm supposed to sing a song called You Are Mine for You. Would that be okay? Well, you're two for two, so go ahead, he replied. I began the song, and tears immediately filled Henry's eyes. As the song went on, healing, soothing tears flowed freely down his cheeks, something Henry really needed to release all his anger. I finished the song and sat quietly without moving for nearly a minute. Finally, I went over to Henry's bed. He smiled and said, "You have just played my three favorite songs." I was surprised that a relatively unknown piece like You Are Mine was his favorite hymn. His wife sang it often in the choir at their Catholic church, and Henry knew the Lord had prompted me to sing it for him. I believe for the first time, Henry began to realize that Jesus loved him very personally and very much. His anger was replaced by God's peace. He smiled, thanked me, and said, "My wife is going to flip when she hears about this." We talked about some of the exciting experiences other patients have had with Jesus and angels. Then Henry's wife came in. He had me tell her about the Lord leading me to play his three favorite songs and asked if I would sing You Are Mine one more time for both of them. His wife sat down next to him on his bed, and as I sang, they cried together, knowing Jesus was speaking directly to them. Psalm 31:7. I will be glad and rejoice in your love, for you saw my affliction and knew the anguish of my soul. Psalm 34:18. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and saves those who are crushed in spirit. Thank you, Lord, for guiding us in all our work for you. Give us eyes to see your grace in our lives.